Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of What the Heck is Steve Talking About? Today, we're gonna go over an introduction to our electrical controls of hydraulics. And that's what this class is all about, right? This is Hydraulics-432 with Mary Romero, and it deals with electrical controls of hydraulics. So let me flip the camera around and we'll get started. So what I'm showing you here is our electrical control module. And what we've got here are a few items. We've got selector switches, some push buttons, some indicator lights, some relays, a time delay relay here, and we've got our power inputs here and line one and line two. But at the heart of this, where we get the power, see, we've got a plug plugged in here and that's given us our power, but ultimately that comes from this electrical power supply. And you can see there that it's 24 volts DC, and that's what we're using to supply all of our components up here. So let me go through just a couple simple little samples here for you, and I'll show you what we can do with this, and we'll end with something really cool, controlling some hydraulics down here. So give me just a minute. Okay, so you know what? On second thought, I'm gonna change things up here for a minute. You know, I'm doing all the work on these videos and I need to get you guys involved in this stuff. So I'm gonna call one of you guys out here to help me wire this thing up. I gotta get somebody out of this class to get in here and actually do some work. So let me, hang on a sec, and let me look here. Michael Becker, Ronnie Diaz, no, David Delphin, William Zanabri, who's this, William, get up here and help me, come here, you William, all right, you're always sitting in the back of the class, I see you nodding your head. Hey, I'm going to have you help me wire up a diagram here. You guys hang tight. I'm going to talk to William about that. We're going to get you something working here, okay? Okay, so you guys saw your classmate William there wire this thing up for me, and it looks like he's done this. This is, again, 24 volts DC, like I told you in the beginning. I showed you the power supply. We're coming into this normally open switch, or actually this is a selector switch is what it is. And it comes over to a red light here, and then it comes out of the red light and goes into the neutral. Notice we did all this with the power off. Right? We always wire these up with the power off. But now we're going to give this a shot and see how it works. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to flip the camera around so you can get a better view of this. All right? So hang tight. Okay. So we've got William here with his circuit that he wired up for us, and we're going to give it a shot. Go ahead and we're going to turn the power supply on. We've got the red light. That means we're good. We've got a main switch up here we're going to turn on. Now our board is powered. And we're ready to turn that selector switch and see how that works. Well, look at that. The red light works. So we've got some electrical controls up here. What we're gonna do next is wire up a directional control valve for you. And what I mean by that is this. Let me recap what we already know. This here is a manual directional control valve, right? We can throw this lever one way or the other. We can make a motor run, or we can extend a rod or retract a rod. We do that by manually throwing this back and forth. We can relate that to like a lever on a forklift, right? You wanna raise the forks, you wanna lower the forks. Well, in this class now, we're moving on to the electrical controls. So we're gonna wire up a circuit that's going to allow us to control some hydraulics. But this time we're gonna do it with an electrically controlled DCV. There's no lever on this DCV, is there? We're gonna do that with these electrical push buttons up here. So give us a minute to get that wired up and I'll be right back with you. All right, guys, so we had classmate William help me wire this up and plumb this up. And ultimately what we have here now is a electrically controlled hydraulic circuit. Again, I'm gonna go back to our regular manual DCV. This is how we cycled them before, right? In previous videos, you saw me moving this lever back and forth, and whatever, things would happen. Motors would spin and see rods moving back and forth. Now we're doing it, we're moving on to electrical controls. So let's give this a shot. Let's fire this thing up and see what happens, okay? Of course, our electricity's off. Here's what we're gonna do though. We're gonna start our pump down here. We're gonna set our relief valve here. Pressure's not real important. It's not a big part of this lab. We're gonna set that up at 400. I'm gonna get William to open the main valve on the left side there. And hopefully what's gonna happen here is we're gonna actuate this cylinder back and forth, but using electrical controls. So I'm gonna have William power up the electrical board, and he's gonna go ahead and push a button. And there we go. That's electrically controlled hydraulics. You can see we've got a pilot light that lights up every time he pushes that button. We're not using a manual DCV valve here. We're doing all of this with electrical controls. So there's some really neat labs coming up that's gonna involve electricity and control of hydraulics. So we've got some more cool stuff coming. So anyway, it's a short video. There you go. Once again, if you have any questions, my email is gonna be listed in the description below. Certainly get a hold of Mary Romero, your instructor, if you have any questions. And we've got a lot more coming at you. So thanks for watching.